I don't care who's in that space right now. I don't care if the job is occupied. I don't care if there's no for sale sign on the house yet. That belongs to me. And it's only a matter of time before I get what's coming to me. And so the Bible says he tells Joshua to see. Note now he tells him to see. He tells him to look, and I want you to look. And when you look at it, I want to see you sitting there. I want you to see yourself walking in authority. I want you to see yourself dwelling in that great city. I want you to see yourself walking in that anointing. I want you to see yourself conquering, being more than a conqueror. I want you to see you there. I wish you all would go on this journey with me on tonight, because I want you to be able to see yourself walking in the strength of the Lord. I know you've been through hardship. You've been through turmoil. You've been through things that you didn't deserve. But God says to us on tonight, he says, see. Look at what I have laid up for you. Where you are now is not where you shall be. I have greater for you. For eyes have not seen and ears have not heard the things that I have laid up for my children. God looks at Joshua and he tells him to see. He says, if you can just see it, if you can just see it, if you can just see it, it'll help you move past your fear. Some of us haven't moved in our destiny yet because we can't quite see ourselves there. Some of us haven't quite moved in the steps that God has carved out for us because we can't quite see ourselves walking in it. But I just want to help somebody here on tonight, because the Bible says that we're more than conquerors. He says you are a royal priesthood and you are a chosen generation. And I don't care what your circumstance looks around you. Don't care what your day-to-day lifestyle looks like right now. If you can just look unto the hills and just see where your help comes from, because when I know my help comes from the Lord, circumstantial evidence don't matter. What he said and she said don't matter. What they think about me and they said about me don't matter, because I see myself walking in the victory. I see my family overcoming. I see my gifts being used. I feel like going crazy on tonight because I can see clearly now. Ain't that what the songwriter said? He said, I can see clearly now that the rain is gone. Oh, I'm not gonna preach that on tonight though. And so the Bible says that God has laid aside for them Jericho and the king thereof, and the mighty men of valor, and ye shall compass the city, all ye men of war, and go round about the city once. Thus shalt thou do 6 days, and 7 priests shall bear before thee the ark, 7 trumpets, and the ram's horn. Note now that they have the ark of the covenant with them, which had a multitude of symbolic meanings, but above all, it was a symbol of the presence of God. The only way for them to overcome this and get the victory was with the presence of God on their side, was with them carrying the presence of God on their every step, which lets me know that even when I clock in on my job tomorrow, I got to have God on my side. Even when I'm walking through my neighborhood on tonight, I got to have the presence of God on my side. Even when I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I won't have no fear or no evil because the presence of God is with me everywhere I go. I wish I had some prayer warriors in here on tonight. Those that get up in the dew of the morning when it's still dark outside, just to get a prayer up to their Lord. Just to let them know that, Lord, I love you. Just to let them know that, Lord, I need you. Can't make it without you. In you I live, move, and have my being. God, I need you to cover my mind on today, because I need your presence to go with me if I'm going to tear down this wall. If I'm going to have the victory, God, I need you to be on my side. And so the Bible says here in verse number 4, it says the 7 priests shall bear before the ark 7 trumpets and the ram's horns, and the 7th day ye shall compass the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow with the trumpets. And it shall come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, and when ye hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout, and the wall of the city, it shall fall down flat. I wish I had somebody in here that can see their walls falling down flat, because you've been looking up at these walls long enough. You've been analyzing how in the world you're going to get over it. You tried to climb up over it and it didn't quite work out. You tried to plot, scheme, and strategize, and it still didn't quite work out. You tried to walk around the wall, and no matter how far you walked, the wall was still there. But I wish I had some faith walkers on tonight that would declare to this wall that's in front of you that it's got to lay down flat. It's got to lay down. It's got to lay down flat. Don't care how long it's been standing up. Don't care how many people it's been defeating. Don't matter how many times I've failed the wall. The wall has got to come down flat. And so the Bible says that when they shout with a great shout, that the wall would come tumbling down. And so I just came to preach unto you tonight about conquering giant walls. Many of us have encountered giant obstacles in our lives, and we've just chalked it up as a loss. We've said to ourselves that maybe this isn't the season, or maybe this isn't the path for me. But I challenge you on tonight to go back to that wall and circle around it one more time. Some of you are on your sixth lap around it, and you're ready to throw in the towel, but God told them to run around it seven times. You see, you thought you've been wasting time in your life, but the time that you've spent looking up at that wall has been God ordained. The times that you've been analyzing that wall had been God ordained, because the children of Israel took seven laps around the wall, and no doubt while they were walking around the wall, Alton, they began to analyze it. They were looking at how thick the wall was. They were looking at how high the wall was. They were looking at the soldiers that were atop of the wall. But while they were looking and analyzing this, they had pure faith, Auntie Jackie, because they knew that the wall was going to be flat, that the brick and the mortar was going to be flat, that the soldiers and the guardians up there were going to be laying down flat, and they were going to get what God had for them that was behind the wall. And so I came to preach to you tonight about getting your praise on to get through the wall. Many of us have tried by our own strength and it didn't work. God says, come back to it with a praise. And when you come back to the wall with the praise, you'll notice the wall decreasing in its strength. When you come back with that hallelujah anyhow, you'll notice that God is going to open up the windows of heaven. Who am I talking to in here on tonight? And he'll pour you out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive. I was in the hospital with my mother, and they had signs all around the rooms, Pam, and the sign said hush. They had a H-U-S-H. It said, help us secure healing. But we looked at the signs while we were waiting for the doctors to come out of surgery. And the doctors came out and said everything went well. They said they were able to cut out every cancerous tumor. And as we looked at the signs, we said, I'm sorry, community hospital. We can't hush on this one. We got to give God a praise. Who am I talking to on tonight? God wants you to give him the praise. Society wants you to hush. The devil wants you to hush. But I challenge you on tonight to turn that H around and put a P in front of the U and praise until something happens. Who's gonna push with me on tonight? I feel a praise coming forth. I feel like giving God the praise, because no weapon that's formed against me is going to prosper. And when the enemy comes in like a flood, that God said he will lift up a standard and he will send them out fleeing. I wish I had some crazy praises in here, because I feel a victory coming. I look unto the hills and I see my help coming. I see the breaking of day, and I can declare on tonight that for God I'll live and for God I'll die. And no matter how high the wall may be, I have got
the victory. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. I feel like doing a victory dance on tonight because the devil thought he had me. The devil thought he had you. The devil thought he had your family. He thought he had your kids. He built up a wall and you said a wall. You've got to come down. Look at that wall and say wall. You've got to come down. Now for the next 60 seconds, I want you to give God a praise. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, push. Woo. Come on, push. That wall's not going to come down from you looking at it. You got to push. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Financial walls come down. Generational curses come down. Depression come down. We call it down in the name of Jesus. We call it down in the name of Jesus. We call it down in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah.